we're going to make a ball using three balloons. Inflate all balloons, leaving about 8-inch flat tail. We're going to twist all bubbles of the same, up to 1-inch size. Let's twist a chain of the first 6 bubbles. We use a pentagon shape as a pattern for this sculpture. We twist each balloon to make 4 connected pentagons. And 4 connected pentagons will make 1 diamond. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 5 bubbles in 1 lock twist. We made the first gray pentagon. Twist the chain of the next 4 bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the first 10 bubbles in 1 lock twist. This instruction is continuous for 2 previously published instructions. We made the second pentagon. Twist the 11th bubble. Lock the free end of the 11th bubble between the next 2 bubbles of the first pentagon. You have to pull the end of the balloon through the loop of the first pentagon. Oops, there are 2 bubbles. I have to retwist. Alright, now twist the chain of the next 4 bubbles. I always try to use the least number of balloons to make any sculptures. This instruction is a good example of this concept. Here we use just 3 balloons instead of 6, as in previously published instruction. Now let's lock both ends of the chain of the last 6 bubbles in 1 lock twist. You have to pull the end of the balloon through the loop of the second pentagon. We have to twist the chain of the next 4 bubbles to make the last gray pentagon. For this sculpture, I suggest to use different color balloons. It makes our job less confusing. Here we have 1, 2, 3 and the 4 bubbles. Now we lock both ends of the chain of the last 5 bubbles in 1 lock twist. Now we twist the last, the 20th gray bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the first 20 bubbles in 1 lock twist. We made 4 pentagons connected in the shape of a diamond. Of course, we can connect bubbles in different ways to make the same diamond. The way we made it is kind of cool. We connected both ends of one balloon in the center of the diamond. We don't need the rest of the balloon. Use scissors or your hands to cut it off and tie off the end. We are going to twist and connect 2 more diamonds. We made each diamond by twisting 20 bubbles. So there is a chain of 3 bubbles on the left and the right side of the diamond. Here's a diamond. The front side looks exactly the same as the back side. And there is a chain of 4 bubbles on the top and on the bottom of the diamond. Let's twist a chain of the first 2 pink bubbles. We're going to lock the free end of the second pink bubble in the middle part of the chain of 4 gray bubbles. I can say it is between the third and the fourth gray bubbles at the bottom of the diamond. You have to force the chain of 2 pink bubbles through the loop of the first gray pentagon. Let's twist the chain of the next 4 pink bubbles. this point we have a chain of 6 pink bubbles. We have to lock both ends of the chain of the last 5 pink bubbles in one lock twist. We made the first pink pentagon. Twist the 7th pink bubble. Lock the free end of the 7th pink bubble between the next 2 gray bubbles. Twist the 8th pink bubble. Lock the free end of the 8th pink bubble between the next 2 gray bubbles. Twist the chain of the next 2 pink bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the first 10 pink bubbles in one lock twist. We made the second pink pentagon. Twist the 11th pink bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 6 pink bubbles in one lock twist. We have to pull the end of the pink balloon through the loop of the first pink pentagon. Twist the chain of the next 4 pink bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 6 pink bubbles in one lock twist. We have to pull the end of the pink balloon through the loop of the second pink pentagon. Twist the 16th pink bubble. Lock the free end of the 16th pink bubble between the next 2 gray bubbles. Twist the 17th pink bubble. Lock the free end of the 17th pink bubble between the next 2 gray bubbles. Twist the chain of the next 2 pink bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 5 pink bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the 20th pink bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the first 20 pink bubbles in one lock twist. We made the second diamond. Now we cut off the rest of the pink balloon. We can do it with hands or let's use the scissors. Tie off the end of the pink balloon. this point, we can use this sculpture to make a basket, a vase, or a bag. But we are going to make a ball, quite a small size ball. Now let's take a closer look on our sculpture. The brim of our sculpture made of 3 chains of pink bubbles and 3 chains of gray bubbles. So there is a chain of 2, chain of 3 and chain of 3 bubbles of each color. We are going to use the blue balloon to make the third diamond. We are going to attach the blue balloon to the chain of 3 pink bubbles located next to the chain of 2 gray bubbles. But first we have to twist the chain of 2 blue bubbles. Now we lock the free end of the second blue bubble between the 2 pink bubbles located right next to the chain of 2 gray bubbles. Very good. Let's twist the third blue bubble. Lock the free end of the third blue bubble between the next 2 gray bubbles. Twist the fourth blue bubble. We lock the free end of the fourth blue bubble between the next 2 gray bubbles. By now you probably noticed already that we twist all balloons for this sculpture in the same way. Twist the chain of next 2 blue bubbles. Now we lock both ends of the chain of the last 5 blue bubbles in one lock twist. We made the first blue pentagon. Twist the 7th blue bubble. Lock the free end of the 7th blue bubble between the next 2 pink bubbles. Twist the 8th blue bubble. Lock the free end of the 8th blue bubble between the next 2 pink bubbles. Now we twist the chain of the next 2 blue bubbles. Lock both ends of the chain of first 10 blue bubbles in one lock twist. We made the second blue pentagon. Twist the 11th blue bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the last 6 blue bubbles in one lock twist. Twist the 12th blue bubble. Lock the free end of the 12th blue bubble between the next 2 gray bubbles. Twist the 13th blue bubble. L- like the free end of the 13th blue bubble between the next two gray bubbles. We can use our ball as a hiding place for smaller size items. So it's about the right time when we can put anything inside of the ball before we finish the sculpture. Now we twist the chain of next two blue bubbles. And then we lock both ends of the chain of the last six blue bubbles. Twisting 60 bubbles takes a lot of time. Plus I spent time showing the sculpture from different sides. You alone can make the ball much faster than I do it in this video. I believe many of you can finish the rest of the ball without my assistance. Anyway, let's twist the 16th blue bubble. Lock the free end of the 16th blue bubble between the next two pink bubbles. Twist the 17th blue bubble. Lock the free end of the 17th blue bubble between the next two pink bubbles. Twist the 18th blue bubble. Lock the free end of the 18th blue bubble between the next two gray bubbles. Twist the 19th blue bubble. Lock the free end of the 19th blue bubble between the next two blue bubbles. Okay, we come to the last bubble. Twist the 20th blue bubble. Lock both ends of the chain of the first 20 blue bubbles in one lock twist. So we made the blue diamond, and congratulations, we just made the ball. You can cut off the rest of the blue balloon and tie off the end. I am just going to hide the rest of the blue balloon inside of the ball. That's it. This is a very nice toy. We can use it to play different games. I posted a description of many games on my blog. If you do it at blogspot.com. All links you can find on our website. Have fun and happy twisting!